So you don't have a photography background, right?
No. So if having a camera means you have a photography background,
right,
then yes, I do. But I don't think that it does.
But education? Yeah.
Absolutely none. I coerced my father into getting me a camera,
right,
in 2001.
Right.
And we told him it's a webcam.
Okay.
Yeah. So it was one of those... actually 1 megapixel but advertised 11 megapixel wala cameras.
Oh, this is right? Interpolated. Right.
And it had a glorious 16 MB of memory.
Memory, right.
And it did not have a screen. So it was, for all practical purposes, it was a film cam. I used to shoot the usual stuff, yeah, sunsets, right, and flowers.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, and then...
We've all done that.
Yes, yeah. So, and I did that for, I think, 6 to 7 years of my life.
Right.
So I think after 2 years, that camera was stolen in Mumbai. Some poor soul ended up with a 1 megapixel 16 MP camera.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's the story.
Qualification wise, you are...
I went to business school.
Yeah.
I'm an engineer from Hyderabad. Typical South Indian boy, yeah. What does a South Indian boy do? First, you become an engineer.
Right.
Then you do an MBA.
Okay, great.
Right? So, 6 years of my life went into really hard education.
And then what happened? What?
Then I sold toothpaste. Again, as South Indian boys do.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Interestingly, in Banaras.
Hmm.
Okay. Yes.
Whoa.
So I was the head of sales for East UP for a toothpaste company.
Right.
And I spent a substantial amount of time. I was there for a year at least in Banaras.
So then the jump to photography, how did that happen?
I was always into photography.
Right.
Okay. So the camera was there as a tool since 2001. And when I took the leap, that was 2010.
Right.
So 10 years in.
Right.
I bought my first salary gifted me my first DSLR.
Right.
1 year in, my first salary hike gifted me my first full frame DSLR.
Oh, nice.
Okay. And I think a point had come when I had spent so much on cameras, I thought maybe I should do something fun with it.
Right.
My sister got married around that time.
Okay.
I googled the terms wedding photography.
Hmm.
Returned almost zero results in India.
This is in
2008. I think two photographers who popped up in India.
Right.
Then I removed India from the search string. And I chanced upon this genre which I had never even knew existed. So if you go to my Flickr page, there's not a single human being in my images.
Right.
As I promised you, flowers and sunsets.
Yeah.
Right? And then I saw this genre which just blew me away. Right? This literally had everything that I always loved. Photojournalism.
Right.
Beauty, light.
Documentary.
Landscapes, yeah. Sports, weddings, yeah, are also like wildlife. Okay. Yeah. They're perfect timing.
Yeah.
It had everything. Okay. Sadly, I did not find anybody for my sister.
Yeah.
So I ended up shooting a bit of a wedding.
Okay.
I liked it. But there was always this doubt, will I actually like doing this for a stranger?
Right.
So then I went ahead and shot a friend's wedding. I shot through that wedding. I uploaded one photo on Flickr of the bride's mehndi. I was already marginally popular on Flickr.
Hmm.
Because I had about 1 million views on Flickr. And when Flickr came to India, they printed my image of the Taj Mahal on hoardings saying Flickr comes to India.
Okay. Nice.
So one of the people who followed my Flickr feed was also an enthusiast photographer, asked me to shoot his wedding.
Right.
And I did. 5 months later, I was shooting a wedding every weekend. Mm-hmm. 10 months, I worked as a business development manager.
Right.
5 days a week.
Right.
And on the weekend, on a Friday, I would mostly take a flight out of Pune shoot a wedding. Monday morning, I'd be back in office. And I would work 9 to 7 every day and then go back home and edit the photos. And then again.
So you were restricted to taking only those assignments.
Only weekends, which, absolutely. Yeah.
So, and then the final leap of faith, how?
I remember vividly, this was the June of 2010. And I was shooting every weekend.
Right.
I was living a life where I had no life. No seeing movies, no outside contact. I had to go 100% with my job and 100% with weddings.
Right.
So then I had a conversation with my immediate boss.
Right.
Who said, this sounds interesting that you're sachi mein shaadi wala photographer banne wala. Right. Mm. And I had a meeting then with my directors and I had just turned 26 and they told me, if you don't do it now, you'll never do this.
Oh,
said, do it. Just like, don't even think about it, just go ahead and do it. So I quit in the end of October 2010.
What is in your camera bag, or what is in Joseph Radhik's camera bag?
So this bag has two parts, which is the top half and the bottom half. And the bottom half actually has an integral part of my wedding photography kit, which are all my waistcoats. Is this top half where my double strap sits, and in the top half is my camera gear, which I will now remove. This is an f-stop bags. I'm going to take all my lenses out.
Okay.
There's usually a second camera in here, but the last shoot I did was a portrait session where I usually carry only one camera. Apart from cameras, you will see one power bank, about 17 TB of storage, two SSDs, spare lens caps, tripod base plate, and a hot shoe mount for my flash. So I carry a lot of data.
Yeah.
A lot of storage devices rather. My primary workflow is to work on solid state drives.
Right.
My laptop has a 1 TB SSD.
Okay.
On top of that, I have an external 1 TB SSD for travel photos.
Okay.
And a 2 TB SSD for wedding photos.
Okay.
Right. The reason why I use SSDs is for the sheer speed, and I don't have to worry about speed dropping
right.
when I'm editing off of these drives.
Right.
These are both backed up into different drives here. This is these guys. Right. And as I said, there's a tertiary backup at home.
So when on location, or suppose, so you take a backup of the data from the cards, of course.
All copy is done to the SSD.
Right.
For the speed of copy.
Okay.
Right. And then the secondary copy is done there.
Okay.
And it's always copy, it's not move.
Okay.
So till this is backed up onto this, these are not wiped out.
Right.
Right. Right. And talking about memory, I use these Sony UF.
You can show it in that camera.
UHS 2, UFS 3 cards, which means that they're third generation cards. These have a read speed of 300 Mbps.
Yeah.
And a write speed of 299 Mbps. Yeah. They're ridiculously fast.
Yeah.
As a wedding photographer, honestly, the difference in writing is not very apparent because these cameras already come with deep buffers.
Buffers, yeah.
The real big difference is when you're copying it after the shoot.
Yeah, that's a pleasure, right?
When you just want to go to sleep,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
It's amazing, yeah. Right? So these things copy onto the SSD at about 150 Mbps, which means typically that's 10 GB a minute.
Right.
Yeah.
And that's nice.
50 GB is done in like 5 minutes. Three photographers on set.
Yeah.
There is a non-photographer on set.
Right.
Right?
Who's
They're called a producer.
Right.
Who is a lot of things wrapped into one.
Right.
Data wrangler, client contact, single point of contact for the client, which means that photographers are not expected to answer their phones. Whole lot of things on set, right? They are the ones with the centralized copy of this data.
Right.
Each of the three photographers have their own copy as well.
Right.
Right? And our entire workflow is DNG. It's not raw.
So that's for the data part. What about lenses? What lenses do you carry? I mean, of course, I can see them, but we want to hear from you. And right here is a 35-1.4. There's a 55-1.8. There is a 85 18 Zeiss Batis.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And 1635 2.8. These seem to be your lenses of choice.
Let me explain.
Yeah.
For the longest time, I did not use a zoom lens.
Yeah.
Okay. My wedding photography was primarily primes. So there's a reason for these four lenses. I want to get to that. All of these choices are based on the final image.
Okay.
Okay. They're not based on cool value. They're not based because an internet reviewer said so.
Yeah.
They're not based because they produce the most beautiful bouquet or anything else.
Right.
They're here because they help me tell a better story. I think a ideal wedding photography kit is actually three lenses.
Right.
Okay. There is your ultra wide, your mid prime, and your tele prime.
Right.
Okay. So this guy is optional. Okay. That's a 55.
Yeah.
So this is, which means your ultra wide is here to help you add drama, work in tight situations, just make things look sexy.
Yeah.
So let's start with this lens. This is a 16-35 G-Master Sony f2.8 lens. Okay. It's about 580 grams.
Yeah.
Hold it. It's not that heavy.
Yeah. Yeah.
It looks big, but it's not that heavy.
Yeah, it's
okay. So here, this guy, the 16-35 is, for me, it's actually five different lenses.
Yeah.
So this is how I use it at a wedding. I am never ever zooming when it's in my hand.
Hmm.
Okay. This is 16. I see it at 16. Right. I approach the scene at 16.
16. Okay.
If most of the time though, I'm at 20.
20. Okay.
Okay. Because 16 is too wide.
Yeah.
Right. So I'm at 20 where I can still manage the distortion. Mm. 30% of the time I'm at 24.
24.
Right.
Okay.
28 is only used at those times when 35 is too tight for
tight,
me.
Right.
Right. It's just a little bit. Right.
Yeah.
Otherwise, my most favored focal lengths in these are 16, not 16. Sorry, 20, 24, and 35. So this is my bread and butter lens.
Right.
This is on my right side.
Right.
Which is my dominant side.
Right.
Right. So again, another little thing. It is never on my left side.
Okay.
It's also the thing. Why? Because keep it simple, stupid.
Yeah.
Blindfold me, I will be able to pick it out of a bag.
Right.
Blindfold me, I'll be able to say that this is my 16-35 on my right. And I also know that this is 35, this is 16.
Right.
Right?
Right.
So during a shoot, I don't want to be confused again.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
That's my 16-35 for you. It typically has a radio trigger on board,
right,
which is triggering an off-camera flash.
Who holds that flash for you, or is it placed
the photographers?
At some? It's
a light stand and a photographer.
Okay.
Right? Either one.
Right.
The 35 is there for meaningful storytelling. For those who haven't tried a 35mm prime, it's possibly the most difficult lens to use.
Yeah.
It doesn't make anything look sexy. It's a very loose lens.
Yeah.
This is an 85mm prime. It makes everything look good because everything blurs out.
Yeah.
And this brings the drama.
That whole dynamism.
Yes,
and
it brings
lines and everything.
Everything else, right?
Yeah.
So suddenly your lights come into the frame, your dancers' ka langas become wider, guys' ka biceps become bigger, sab kuch ho jata hai isme, right? So 16 and 85, sexy stuff.
Right.
35, not so much.
Yeah.
Which means that this lens will teach you to compose.
True.
Right? Actually, let me rephrase that. This focal length will
teach you to compose.
Because this is also a 35mm for me. So when does the 35 come out for me? It'll come out when the light is too less. It'll also come out when the arena is very big.
Okay.
When I may never use the 16.
Right.
Okay. But primarily this is there for the light.
Right.
Because even when I'm shooting with this, I'm at 2.2, 2.4.
Okay.
I'm not at 1.4.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
So it's when the truth is though, there are only three quality 16-35 2.8s in the world.
Hmm.
Sony makes two of them, one for the E mount and one for the A mount.
A mount, right.
And Canon makes the new L3. They're all very expensive lenses.
Right.
They're very, very expensive.
Yeah, and they're very, very good.
They're very, very good. Which means that you need to, it has to be good enough to be three primes or four primes in by itself. I trust this lens to be as good as this unbelievably good lens.
Right.
Right. So that's, let's get that out of the way. Let's talk about this now. Okay.
The not so humble 55mm.
Yeah.
1.
So 55 or 85.
Yeah.
it depends a lot on what your wide angle is. I believe that lenses, the next thing I said, everybody should have three lenses. These three, maybe. This is a wide angle prime, is what I'm saying. If you can afford it, get a 16-35. But where does the 55 come in then? I have a term that I use regularly called working distance.
Right.
Right. So if I'm using two cameras, one is a tele and the other is a wide.
Right.
If my wide is a 35 mm, my tele is the 85.
85.
Okay. Which means that I have enough distance to use the 85.
Right.
If my wide is 24 to 16 mm,
right,
which is where this guy might be, then the 55 is my tele.
Right.
Right? It means that I'm closer to my subject.
Right.
Hence, I cannot use the 85.
85.
Yeah. Which means that, again, from a story point of view, if I'm 16 to 24 level stuff, I am too close. Right? And at 85, I might only get like that much.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right?
You probably won't be able to make out who
correct.
Eyes belong to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The distance you stay from the subject is the distance your audience stays from the subject.
Right.
So you want to put somebody in the story, you go close.
Yeah.
I'm not saying you shoot wide, you go close. So because in a wedding, if you're not tuned in,
right,
you will never get that moment.
Right, right.
And you will always be wondering, why are my photos lacking that level of intimacy and level of that emotion.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. So it could mean also that if I'm in a vast arena, I may pick up the 85.
Right.
Right. But that's pretty much it. So this is my core. I don't see the need for anything beyond this. I am going to talk about the camera now.
Yeah.
This is a Sony A7R Mark III. Primary reason when I shifted to mirrorless 3 years ago was weight, because my back was giving up. But today the reason I use mirrorless is it genuinely is the best technology out there. In this generation of cameras, and this is the third generation now, these are no compromise now. Okay, the autofocus is not as good as a DSLR. It is actually better than a DSLR, especially when the light goes down.
You also use an A9.
I also use the A9. So that's my second camera.
Okay.
Right. So A7 R3 is my primary camera.
Right.
And the A9 is my secondary camera on the tele side.
Right.
The A7 R3 is mostly used with flash. When I'm using a flash, the A9 is all natural light.
Okay.
So this is it's a mechanical shutter camera that shoots. Is my mic here? No. So I should be able to.
Yeah.
That's 10 FPS. It's a lot like an old sewing machine, right?
Yeah.
It's 10 FPS, full autofocus, full auto exposure, and most importantly, it goes up to 80 raw frames. At 42 megapixels.
Right.
Right? That's just incredible, right? For me, it's important because I don't shoot 10 FPS firstly, but that response time of that shutter is so good right now.
Right.
Yeah, it's as good as any high-end DSLR.
Do you shoot silenced shutter a lot? Do you?
I shoot with the A9.
Okay.
I shoot with the A9. I shoot when the bride's getting ready.
Right.
I shoot when there's a vidai happening.
Right.
Right? Because it's not that people are crying, it's just that it's a solemn moment. And I also shoot when I believe that the cinematographers don't want to be disturbed by. So you have to be aware of your surroundings.
Nice.
Right? So if there's another team shooting,
right,
do them a favor, right? Instead of somebody is emoting very well, dad walks in and dad is like, oh my God, you look so beautiful.
Hmm.
And the bride is like, yeah, I can't believe it's the day. Right?
Yeah, yeah.
So like, it's just like we have seen it happen, right?
Yeah,
you will kill the moment.
Yeah.
So yeah, be nice to people, right?
Be of service.
Correct. Be of service even to the other team members. Silent shutter in this is truly silent.
Right.
It's a fully electronic shutter. It's not the anti-distortion shutter that's on the A9.
Right.
The A9 is the true big daddy of silent shutters. So this camera comes with this new battery.
FZ100.
Yes, battery, yes. Which is about 3 to 4
is
times.
Is it FZ100?
It is the FZ100. You got it right.
Yeah.
I travel with 3 batteries
right.
across 2 cameras. Because these are good enough for me to last throughout the day.
Superb.
Throughout the day.
Yeah.
Okay. So I don't carry chargers. Typically what happens is, camera on the right, my wide runs out of battery.
Right.
Because that's where I'm mostly shooting. That's it. That's pretty much it. Keep it
you
simple.
You don't carry chargers means you don't carry chargers to location.
Yes. Okay. I don't carry chargers. They're in the hotel.
Okay.
They're in the hotel. So typically in my check-in bag, I mean, you can't check in batteries. So in my big bag, I have 3 batteries.
Right.
And it takes, I think, about 1.5 hours to charge by the time the next event is. Next. So that's fine.
Superb.
It's keep it simple, stupid. Right?
So, and what about this?
That's my strap. The reason I use the hold fast is because it distributes the weight so well.
Yeah, I just tried it on.
Nice, no?
Yeah, it's like really amazing. And it's a dual camera
Correct.
Strap,
Correct.
Which, you know, you sling across.
Hmm.
It makes you feel good. And
it looks good.
It looks good, and I think, I mean, it's really, really solidly
it's,
built.
Truth be told, none of this is inexpensive.
Right.
But it's also no compromise.
Right.
What you don't see here is my lighting kit.
Right.
My lighting kit is 2 or 1 Pro Photo even. Mostly, it's only one light that I light with. I have been a great fan of Joe McNally.
Hmm.
Right.
Hmm.
And it's one light.
This.
Just the one light. One simple choto little light.
Yeah.
Beyond that, on camera, do I use a flash?
Yeah.
Yes, when the situation demands it. I have a TT350. It's a Godox.
Yeah.
It's just this much.
Yeah.
And it balances very well on
this. We have that too.
Yeah. So because small camera, big flash, doesn't sit. Right. In fact, actually the best combination here among all of these is this guy. So this 55.
Yeah.
On this, it's just, this is just perfect.
This is just,
yeah. So when I'm lazy at a wedding, this is what I shoot with. Okay. When I feel like both ho gaya hai, you know, composition, to chuda, take a break.
Yeah.
Right. That's, I think, the core of it. That's the core of it. I carry extra back caps because I keep losing them.
Right.
These are from eBay. $10 gets you 20 of these.
All right.
Okay.
So when you
shipped
said
from China,
when you said $10, I said, so why wouldn't you buy the original? Because you know,
20.
Yes.
20. Right. My big suitcase has 10 of these.
Right.
Always, because I keep losing them.
Right? Sure.
They'll fall off somewhere. I don't care. Mm-hmm. Right. So if they're gone, it's fine. I also have the moment I buy a new, you know, this is a new lens, but usually the moment I buy a lens, I have these unbranded lens caps.
Yeah.
Okay, because these are really nice,
yeah.
And I don't know how many of you guys know, but these are bloody expensive. I have them in 67, 62, 55, 72, 82, all the way,
all
generic.
The way.
Same thing, $10 gets you 20 of these.
Superb.
So we have a basket full of these in office, and it's okay, you can lose how many ever you want. Hot shoe stands, very important, spare hot shoe stands.
Right.
Because you can just put the flash on it and forget about it, right? And
talk about a tripod. Do you carry a tripod?
I don't, actually. Not to a wedding.
Okay.
I do carry a light stand.
Right.
And one continuous light. We have a range of continuous lights, one ring light, two ice lights, etc. But again, they rarely come out.
Okay.
We only bring them out if the situation demands it. Right. So if I'm able to see that I'm at the bride's room, say, and it's very dim and there's nothing I can do with my flash, which is too powerful for that.
Right.
I will then call the second photographer to
light it up with a continuous light.
Correct.
Okay.
So it's even the softbox, modifiers. Right.
Right.
We have something called a SunDisk. It's a Kickstarter thing. Before that, we used to have SMDV softboxes.
Right.
Anything that is portable, compact, and can be used on location.
Yeah.
That's the thing with
just twist it into and put it in a bag.
Pretty much, tripod. I will take it if I'm shooting in a pre-wedding in a desert.
Right.
Anywhere where I might want to do a long exposure.
Right.
Never to a wedding itself.
Okay.
Okay. That's it. Keep it simple, stupid.
That sounds like a lot, but it actually isn't, because it just you know you saw the bag that it fits in.
It's actually a lot lesser than what the average wedding photographer travels.
Yeah. So that's it for now. Subscribe to our channel and share this video with your friends, because Joseph Radhik has just revealed what gear he uses.
Yes.
And until the next video, bye-bye.
Peace.
If you really love photography, personal work is critical to do. Finding money in photography is not always easy. The most important thing is be happy in your photography. You've got to have that attitude that you're happy with your photography, that you're doing what you want.